Hi everyone. Okay, this is Ullman versus Bunch, which was played in Halle in 1976. It's a great example of the hedgehog defense to the English opening c4, like so. So the opening usually goes as follows. Black responds to c4 with c5 symmetrically, then knight f3, knight f6, knight c3, e6, g3, b6, bishop g2, bishop b7, d4, c takes d4, queen takes d4, d6. Now, some basic information about the hedgehog. It's a setup which was developed during the 1970s and has remained popular ever since under the generic name of the hedgehog. Black sets up a row of pawns along the third rank and develops his pieces behind them. White enjoys a substantial space advantage, and according to classical canons of positional play, he should have a substantial advantage. However, the hedgehog formation contains a good deal of hidden dynamics. Black's position rather resembles a coiled spring, which can rebound against the attacker with a great deal of power. Essentially, it is a counter-attacking system. White is invited to push forward with his pawns, especially on the king side, whereupon black can hit back with a counter based on the pawn advances b5 and or d5, and also sometimes e5. So, normal development continues. Knight on b to d7 is all part of the normal hedgehog build-up. The knight is better here than on c6, where it would obstruct the action of the black queen's bishop. From d7, the knight protects its colleague on f6 and has the possibility of jumping to c5 or e5 at an appropriate moment. So, play continues. Queen e3, castles, knight d4, queen c7, b3, a6, bishop a3. Black's most obvious weakness is a d6 pawn, and so this move appears logical. However, the pawn can easily be defended, with the attack from the bishop being blocked by knight c5 if necessary, and so the bishop is probably better placed on b2. This is followed by rook fe8, which is typical of the tactics of the hedgehog. With the rook here, it's eyeing the queen, and so with later d5 breaks, there'll be tactical opportunities with the knights and the pin being exploited. Okay, so after that we have h3 and bishop f8. This unmasks the rook that attacks the queen indirectly, and also the bishop defends g7, and quite often the bishop will later redeploy to the long diagonal after g6. So, rook fe1. Now we have a typical hedgehog position. Both sides have developed their pieces in a fairly standard formation, and it is now up to white to decide how to proceed. His natural plan is a kingside pawn advance, but this entails the risk of allowing a black counterattack, and must therefore be carefully prepared. Rook a d8. Yeah, in this variation, the rook more usually belongs on c8 in the semi-open file, but in this specific position, Bunch sees that it has more future on d8. So, rook a d1, knight c5. This pressurizes the e4 pawn and blocks the a3 bishop. White could push the knight away with b4 at some stage, but this would severely weaken the c4 pawn. Provoking these kind of weaknesses is the essence of Black's play in the hedgehog. Next there was f3. Which isn't really a good move. White decides to overprotect his e4 pawn, but it restricts the action of his g2 bishop and also weakens the white king side. Then we have g6, bishop g4, bishop g7. Given that white has no serious pressure against the d6 pawn, there is no reason for this bishop to remain on f8. It therefore transfers to a more active position on the long diagonal. In addition, the move g6 has ensured that the knight can go to h5 in the event of white playing g5. Then we had bishop b2 and bishop a8, which is kind of like a waiting move. Black is playing cat and mouse, and it's designed to create white to push his pawns and create weaknesses. Also here, the immediate breakout d5 instead was not possible because of g5. After knight fd7, e takes d5, e takes d5, queen takes e8 check, rook takes c8, rook takes c8 check, white stands better. So, after bishop a8, there was rook e2, and then h6. And this secures the position of the knight on f6. Rook d1, queen b8. Again, this is a typical hedgehog move. The queen supports a possible b5 break at some point. Then came queen d2. And this is because black's last few moves have prepared the d5 break, and white therefore takes action against that move. The regrouping of his major pieces prepares to meet d5, with c takes d5, e takes d5, and then e5, in which white would stand better, as the d5 pawn is isolated and obstructs black's a8 bishop, while white has a secure blockade on the d4 square. However, black has an alternative break with which he seizes the initiative, and that is after queen d2, e5. And this is followed by knight c2. Now we see another point of black's 17th move, which ensured that white cannot now play his knight into f5. Then came the next break, b5. C takes b5 followed this, which is essentially a blunder. Knight to e3 was much safer, because now black strikes with his other key break in such positions, d5, after b5, c takes b5, d5, e takes d5, knight takes d5, knight takes d5, rook takes d5. Compared with just 5 moves ago, the position has been totally transformed. The black pieces now spring into action with a vicious counterattack that sweeps all resistance before it. Queen e3, knight d3, rook b1, knight takes b2. Now black has a dangerous bishop pair. Rook takes b2, e4. And now another black piece springs into play. The dark square bishop is attacking this rook. So, rook b1, rook d3, queen f2, e takes f3, rook takes e8 check, queen takes e8, bishop f1, rook c3. So, in the space of just 10 moves, white's powerful looking position has been decimated, and all of the black pieces radiate power. The immediate threat, if white does nothing about it, say for example a3, is rook takes c2, queen c2, queen takes c2, bishop to d4, check, with a quick mate to follow. So in order to stop that, after rook c3, black played rook d1. This was followed by a takes b5. Now black has a solid extra pawn to go with his positional advantages. Knight d4, queen e4. Bishop takes b5, which is better than knight takes b5, which would be met by rook to c2, in which case black is much stronger. So, after bishop takes b5, rook to c1, and it's all over. There's no defense to the attacks here. For example, rook takes c1. Bishop takes d4 and the queen is gone. So, that's the end of the game, and it's a great example of the dynamic hedgehog. I recommend that you use it. I use it in a lot of my online games and I've had some great results with it. Okay, I hope you enjoyed that. Thanks very much. Please leave any comments and thoughts.